哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣灵正道。
Hallelujah, in the name of the Lord Jesus, I speak.
靠着圣灵的帮助。
By the help of the Holy Spirit.
我们继续来分享雅各书中里面的智慧的信息。
We continue to share on the message of wisdom in the book of James.
在第一章我们看到雅各书里面的五种智慧。
In the first chapter, we saw five wisdom in the book of James.
那么五种智慧它所结出来的果子是什么呢？
What is this fruit out of this five wisdom?
这五种智慧它所表现的所做的见证是什么呢？
What is this testimony that's been demonstrated by these five types of wisdom?
这五种智慧所结出的果子所表现的所见证的就是真实的信仰。
The fruits that have been born and also the testimony that's been testified by these five wisdom is the genuine faith.
所以进入第二章的时候就是在见证什么叫做真实的信仰。
As we enter into chapter 2, we are able to witness what is this genuine faith all about.
但是这真实的信仰一定要有前面的五种智慧来去支撑行出来。
But this genuine faith has to be supported by the pillars of these five wisdom in the previous chapter.
那么这个真实的信仰也叫做智慧的信仰。
And this genuine faith is also known as the faith of wisdom.
因为是五种智慧所结出来的果子。
Because it is but a result or the fruit of this five wisdom.
那么这真实的信仰也叫做真实的信心。
And this genuine faith is also known as a genuine belief and faith.
那么这个真实的信仰到底是怎样的信仰呢？它有什么表现呢？
What kind of genuine faith? What would this faith manifest?
那么这里一共有两个长老呢，雅各书有提出三个真实信仰的见证。真实信仰的表现。
James here pointed out a few examples of this manifestation of true faith.
我们来看，先看第一个真实的信仰的见证。
We look at the first testimony by this about this true faith.
就是一节到七节的第一个见证。
The testimony found in verses 1 to 7.
那真实的信仰呢，必须要有公义的见证。
This true and genuine faith has to manifest this testimony of righteousness.
你说你的信仰是真的，那你一定会有公义的表现，公义的行为。
You claim that your faith is genuine, but and you have to manifest righteous acts.
所以我们先读第一节。
Verse 1. My brethren, do not hold the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord of glory, with partiality.
是吗？第一节一开始就提醒我们，我们的信仰是一个怎样的信仰？
Verse 1 reminds us what kind of faith is our faith.
我们的信仰到底是信什么的？
What do we actually believe in?
这里说，我的弟兄们啊，我们是信奉我们荣耀的主耶稣的呀，我们是信耶稣的人来的呀。
My brethren, we are the ones who hold the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ.
而且我们所信的耶稣是荣耀的主耶稣呀。
Who is also the Lord of glory.
那我们所信的信仰呢，就是相信荣耀的耶稣。
Our faith is one where we believe in the glorious Lord of Lord Jesus Christ.
那就是信奉主耶稣所有的一切，他所做的，他所行的，他所讲的，他所吩咐的，一切的一切，耶稣所做的，我们都相信，都成为我们的信仰。
Where we plant our faith in all the things about Jesus and all the works that he has done and all the words that he has spoken.
那你的信仰是什么？
So what is your faith?
我信仰就是信主耶稣呀。
Our faith is in Jesus Christ.
信耶稣什么？
What do we believe about?
就信耶稣所做的、所讲的、所一切的一切呀。
We believe all his works and all the words that he spoke.
那这个才叫做真正的相信耶稣。
That is what we call truly believing in Christ.
今天不少神学家、神学博士那些有名望的有出名的，他们已经不相信耶稣所讲的。
Today we have countless theological scholars and academicians who have stopped believing.
他们在神学院教导做教授教导学生神学生的时候，他们不信耶稣的神迹，很多神迹被他们否认掉。
In these theological courses, they teach about the theology and Jesus Christ, but they have denied the Lord Jesus Christ.
那主耶稣所吩咐的，你们要信而受洗，必然得救，不一定。
And
不一定要受洗。
As commanded by Jesus Christ, you be baptized and be saved, and they say it is okay not to be baptized.
耶稣说：“你们不洗就与我无分。”那个洗脚的他们说：“不用的，那是风俗，不要听耶稣讲。”
Jesus commanded that
不要听耶稣讲，你听好来哦。
If I do not wash your feet, you shall have no part with me. But they say they do not have to listen to what Jesus.
我信耶稣当然要听耶稣讲呀。
But you believe in Christ, you have to believe in His words.
我信耶稣不听耶稣讲，我到底信什么？我信什么？我到底？难道是信你吗
？You claim you believe in Christ, but you don't believe in His words, and do I actually believe in you?
不用的，不用照耶稣讲的来做的，不用的，那是风俗来的。耶稣讲要，你说不要。
So they claim that it's okay, don't have to follow because it's just human tradition and custom.
耶稣说这个是与你得救有关系，与你跟我有没有份的问题。你说那个是风俗，那个是犹太人的风俗，中东的风俗，你真的在讲什么呀？
But what Jesus said was that this is to have a part with Jesus Christ, and you claim that it's just human tradition.
那我随便提出，就是告诉我们，今天很多人说他信耶稣，他的信仰哦是不信耶稣的，至少不信耶稣所讲的，不信耶稣所做的。
This is just some brief examples to point out that many people today claim that they believe in Jesus Christ, but they don't believe in the faith preached by Jesus.
请问这样子是你是在信耶稣吗？
And can I ask you, is this truly believing?
请问你这种信仰是真正的信仰吗？
Is your faith true and genuine?
不要再骗人了。
Stop deceiving yourself.
这是很严重，将来要受审判的呀。
This is very serious because you will be judged.
这里说，我的弟兄们啊，我们是信奉我们荣耀的主耶稣的呀，我们就是信他的呀。
He tells us that, my brethren, we are the ones who hold the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ.
那真实的信仰呢，必须要有真实的行为。
And true and genuine faith comes with true and genuine behavior and action.
有真实的见证。
With true testimonies.
有真实的表现。
With true manifestation.
那信仰的行为见证到底是什么呢？
What are these works that are manifested in
our faith? 那么第一节说，真实的信仰呢，真实的信耶稣呢，就是不可以按着外貌来待人。
This true and genuine faith is one without partiality, based on how people look.
不按外貌待人，其实这个就是公义的表现。
And you do not judge by the looks of other people, and that is also a work of righteousness, justice.
因为公义是不会偏待人的，也不看你的背景的，也不是看你有钱或没有钱的，公义。这些在公义的面前都站立不住的。
Because justice do not count the looks of other people, the background, and the circumstances.
今天社会上有这么多不公义的事情，就因为他偏待人，按外貌来待人啊，因为你没背景啊，因为你没有钱啊，因为你没有学问啊，因为你没有这个，你没有那个呀。
Today, there are many social injustices that happen because people show partiality for those who look better, who are better educated, who are of higher status.
那么社会上有这样的偏待人不公义的事，那太多了，我们就不需要再讲了。
There are so many of such social injustices, we don't even have to mention it.
那我们要讲的就是当时教会的情形，使徒教会的情形也是这样呀。
But I'm just pointing out to you that it was the same exactly during the time of the apostles.
教会里面确实有不公义的行为，有偏待人的行为啊。
There was a incidence of injustice in the church.
而且很出面的，很清楚的。
It was also very blatant, very brazen.
那个我们看二节到，请读二节到四节。
Verse 2 to verse 4.
这是在讲教会里面哦。
This is regarding what happened in the church.For if there should come into your assembly a man with gold rings in fine apparel, and there should also come in a poor man in filthy clothes, and you pay attention to the one wearing the fine clothes and say to him, you sit here in a good place, and say to the poor man, you stand there, or sit here at my footstool. Have you not shown partiality among yourselves and become judges with evil thoughts?
这里所描述的是实实在在当时教会里面的情形啊。
This is a description of what exactly happened in the church back then.
有一个戴着金戒指、穿名牌衣服进会堂的时候呢，哇，大家请他去上座，请上座。
Someone embroidered with gold rings and a beautiful branded apparel, they will receive a warm welcome.
而且你注意到吗？坐在最好的位置上，留给他们的。
And they have a place reserved for them.
他们只是有钱罢了吗？他们不一定说行为很好的，知道吗？
All they had was money, and they may not have good conduct.
可是有一个贫穷的信徒呢，他穿着脏衣服进来，贫穷的。
But a poor member came in filthy clothes.
那么接待的人怎样对他讲呢
？How did the reception react?
你站在那边吧，你连坐都没有。站在那边吧，你连进来坐都没有。
Please stand there. You shouldn't even come in.
如果你真的要坐呢？如果你一直在吵呢？可以吧？那就坐在我的脚凳下吧。坐在人家的脚凳下吧。
If you insist to come in, okay, you can sit at my footstool.
你是怎样安排的？你是怎样来断定他可以坐好位，他可以坐，他可以站坐？你是怎样来判断的
？What is your rationale in deciding for him to sit here or sit there?
原来就是看他有没有钱呐、啊，看他有没有戴戒指啊，看他有没有穿名牌衣啊。就是这样来判断的呀。
Turn out that you decided upon what he wore, whether he wore branded clothes or whether he was clean and not filthy.
你不是判断他是不是爱主的，是不是圣洁的，是不是忠心的，是不是主的儿女？你不是这样判断的哦。
But you did not decide upon whether he was holy, whether he was faithful to God, whether he was a child of God.
这个是当时教会的情形。
That was what happened in the church.
两个长老把这种教会的情形很不客气的写出来，公告出来，责备这些人。责备当时的教会。
Elder James wrote this down very clearly, very blatantly to rebuke the members back then.
那我们那个是使徒教会，那请问今天末世真耶稣教会有没有我们的教会有没有这种行为呢？有没有这样的人呢？
This was in the apostolic era, but do we have this kind of things happening in today's church?
所以第四节雅各就断定了，做个结论了。
Verse 4, Elder James made a conclusion.
这岂不是你们偏心待人吗？
Have you not shown partiality among yourselves?
而且呢，是用恶意来断定人，用恶的，那是恶的，恶的是从撒旦来的，从世界来的，从不善良来的。
Furthermore, you made judgment out of evil thoughts, and these evil thoughts came from the devil.
所以他不只是说偏待人、看不起人，他还带着恶意啊，那个是撒旦，有撒旦的意思在里面的呀。
Not only did you show partiality, you also have evil intent and thoughts coming all the way from the devil.
那个是那个简单说，就是雅各断定说，这个就是恶的行为。
And in simple words, James said that this was evil thoughts and evil works.
在公义的面前哦，不允许这些恶的行为出现的。
In the face of justice and righteousness, there's no room for evil intent.
那我们检讨一下，我们的信仰里面有没有这样恶的行为存在？
It's time for us to examine ourselves whether we have these evil thoughts in our hearts.
我很痛心的说，我很痛心的说，我们教会确实有存有一些人有这样的行为，有这种恶的行为。
Now with a broken heart, I'm telling you that there are indeed members who have these evil thoughts in their hearts in the church.
不要说传道一直讲谁教会，这个是我的教会，我所爱的教会啊。
Stop saying that I'm just here to scold and rebuke and also say bad things about
the church. 我们甚至可以付出生命来为他牺牲的呀。
I love my church and I sacrifice my life for
her. 甚至也丢到这个世界，丢到什么来爱护这个教会的，不是吗？
Didn't I also forsake the world and forsake everything that I had to love my church?
今天要这样讲，就是真的爱教会才这样讲。
And for someone to be able to say this, he is one who really truly loves the church.
因为公义。
Because of justice.
教会一定要有公义。
The church must have justice.
不偏待人。
With no partiality.
不看外表，不看钱财，不看背景。
With no regard for the outer appearance, wealth, and also background.
有一个信徒，他本来就是很软弱，不是常常去教会。
There was a believer who was weak in his faith.
但是那天他说他是可能是被圣灵感动吧。他说他就是一直想要去教会。
But one fine day, perhaps he was moved by the Holy Spirit. He wanted to come to church.
他是做建筑的，建筑工人来的。
He was working in the construction industry.
那天也没有什么工作哦，做了半天哦，他就跟他的老板说，那他就到教会去了。
There was not much construction work, not much work that day, so he decided to come to church after work.
所以他想要去教会守安息日，去教会聚会安息日。
He wanted to keep the Holy Sabbath on that day.
这不是圣灵感动吗？
Wasn't that moved by the Holy Spirit?
结果因为他穿着这个做工衣服来教会，有一个信徒对他讲，很不客气的，也很大声的对他讲。
But when he arrived at the church and someone at the reception told him very rudely,
而且他的那个样子表现哦，好像你最好你离开了，你最好走开了。
And that person was also having that very uncourteous look.
后来他就直接说了，如果以后你再穿这样的衣服来，你不用再来了，你不要来教会了。
He said very directly and saying that if you are dressed like that, do not come to church.
这件事情我问得很清楚，他真的是这样讲吗？
I asked that very clearly and he told me this.
这个当事人说，是的，我听得很清楚，所以我很愤怒，我非常的生气。
And this brother told me exactly what happened and he was really angry.
因为我也怕我听错呀。
I was afraid that I misheard.
但是清清楚楚讲得很大声，讲得很清楚呀。
But it was loud and clear, very clearly spoken.
这个弟兄他想到，我都已经这么久没有来，圣灵感动我，我也觉得应该要来聚会。
This brother was thinking to himself that he was inspired by the Holy Spirit. He did not come to church for the longest time.
而且是从直接从工厂来啊，不是回家里冲凉，没有时间呢。
And he rushed all the way from the factory, and he didn't have time to go to the to go home.
我们这样讲是不是很让人家很受伤呢？让人家很痛苦呢
？If you said such words, then wouldn't you have hurt his feelings?
你知道这件事情哦，让他多少年没来聚会，你知道吗？没有到教会，你知道吗
？You know how many years went past after he faced
this? 这个讲话的人要负责任啊。
This person who spoke such words must be responsible.
整二十年不到教会来，怎样劝了他都不要来。
This brother never came to church for two decades.
是后来。有一个机会了哦，接触到他才讲出这件事情。
It was only with an opportunity that he finally came to meet us, and he told us this story.
我在想，如果他是一个建筑老板
If he was a construction owner.
而且他这个老板也是自己亲自下属做工的，他很随和的。
And if he owned a construction company, and he was a very hands on.
他在教会也奉献很多钱，奉献不少钱的。
And perhaps he offered a lot of money in the church.
那你也认识他的。
And you know all about that.
那有一天他这样穿着衣服流着汗这样冲到教会来聚会，请问你敢这样叫他离开吗？请问。你讲老实话，你叫他说，你以后不要来，你敢这样讲吗
？This big boss of this construction company came in with this filthy clothes and uniform. Would you dare to chase him away？
今天我们可以跟一个平凡的信徒，一个打工的人讲这种话，你是凭什么这样讲呢
？But you dared to speak such harsh words to this ordinary member dressed in this construction uniform？
第二个事情。
A second incident.
有一个残缺的，就是身体上有残缺的一个慕道者。
There was a
truth, 来我们教会听道理。
Truth seeker who has certain disability.
嗯，他有时早来，有时比较迟来。
And he sometimes he would be late, sometimes he would be early.
啊，比较迟来啊，所谓迟来也还没有正式聚会了，也还没有正式，还没有开，还没有聚会。
And that is to say that before the service started, he already came.
但是也有一些弟兄姐妹已经到了。
But there are some brothers and sisters who were in the church.
所以他就比较坐后面去的。
So he would be seated at the far end.
那天他比较早到，教会没有什么人，只有两三个人而已。
And one day he came really early, and there was only two or three members.
所以他就跑到前面的第二排是第三排来坐吧。
So he came all the way to the front pews to sit.
这样比较专心听得到道理，也比较听得清楚吧。
Because perhaps it would be clearer to him, for him to hear the sermon.
反正不懂他的目的是什么，他跑到走到前面来听道理。是被允许的。
Regardless of whatever his reason, he was allowed to come to the front of the front seat.
可是就有一个信徒哦，脸黑黑的，很不高兴哦，整个脸都黑黑了，大家都看到了，大家都心里知道了，哎，那个位置是他坐的，每次他坐的，糟糕了。有一些信徒已经心想了，有把戏看了，有戏看了，
there...
真的在那边做戏了，就有戏看了。
And then there came a brother with a very sour or very angry face coming to the front, looking at him because he took his place.
嗯，就脸黑黑的对他说，也是很不客气哦。
With a very curt and a very bitter face, he said,
你到后面去坐。
You sit behind.
这位置不是你坐的。
This is not your seat.
那些人在看，一些弟兄姐妹在看呢。看这件事情发生，他们心里已经知道了，一定会发生，真的发生。
Some brothers and sisters witnessed this, and they already knew that it was coming.
我也要责备这些弟兄姐妹。
But I want to rebuke all these people.
你们是在看戏吗
？Are you watching a drama？
你们什么心态在让这件事情发生呢？你们有去调和吗？或者有是劝这个信徒说你不可以这样呀
？What kind of attitude？
你不可以这样子呀？你有没有劝他呢？
What kind of attitude are you having while you watch this happen? Didn't you have the heart to make peace and reconcile with them?
甚至是责备他这样的行为呢？责备的他说：“你这样的行为不对，不合乎真理，也不是主耶稣的榜样来的。”
To the extent, shouldn't you be admonishing this brother who said all these harsh words? And that was not an example of Jesus.
有什么资格条件说那个位置一定是你的？你买的吗
？What right do you have that you own that seat?
你那边有写明说是你的吗？也没有。
Did the seat bear your name？
因为他这个是一个外邦的，一个慕道者，一个贫穷的外邦人啊，因为他残缺的，穿的也是落落扣扣啦，破，我也没有说破烂啦，就是你看到就是一个贫穷人就是啦。
But
一个弱势团体就是啦。
Perhaps it was because that this disabled friend was only a truth seeker who was dressed very shabbily and very poor and a minority.
过后没有一个信徒，甚至里面的负责人没有一个人是来主持公道，没有。
But none of the believers came to hold justice.
就让那个慕道者这样受伤的，这样的受伤，没有人来替他讲话。
This truth seeker was hurt to the heart, and no one.
所以那个信徒更勇敢哦，谁敢骂他？谁敢讲他？没有人敢啊。
So this believer who was so harsh must have felt very.
这个信徒是代表勇敢有头勇敢的呀，不是普通信徒啊，我不好意思讲太清楚呀。
I cannot tell who he is, but he is someone who has.
因为我再讲清楚，大家就知道是谁呀。
Who has a place in the church？
可是这种行为是不对的啊，应该被责备的呀。
But this kind of behavior must be admonished.
那当然是这位信徒的不对。
And of course, this brother might.
那我请问，在场这么多几十个信徒，难道你们的行为就对吗？ 静静，大家静静还在看把戏，看把戏发生，你们的行为对吗？
It is true that his brother has done wrong, and didn't those who were present there also do wrong? Did they just watch without any heart to help them?
今天我在教这刚才讲的事情，就跟雅各书当在这里讲的一模一样的呀。
This
incident 就是一模一样的事情来的呀。
It's exactly the same as what is spoken here by Elder James in chapter 2.
我们再看第四节。
We look at verse 4.
这岂不是你们偏心待人吗？用恶意断定人吗？恶的。
Have you not shown partiality and you have judged with evil thoughts?
请大家注意。
Take note of this.
主耶稣的心意是什么？
What is the heart of Jesus?
请看第五节。
Verse 5.
我亲爱的弟兄们啊，请你听啊，
Listen.
请你谦卑的听，用心的听啊。
Listen with humility, my beloved brethren.
啊，听什么？
What is to listen?
神岂不是拣选了世上的贫穷人吗？
Has God not chosen the poor of this world?
特别记载神特别拣选世上的穷人，因为这些穷人最需要的，最需要被关怀，最需要被帮助，最需要被尊重的，最需要被爱的，不是那些有钱人，不是那些有钱人不需要你去爱，
is,
他们也不要你的爱，你的爱算什么？
This is written so crystal clear that we are here to save those who are poor, who are needy, and they need respect, they need love, they need your care.
主耶稣知道他们生活很辛苦，他们的人好生活人生都很贫穷，也被人家看不起，也被人家欺负，所以主耶稣特别在信上，在信仰上给他们富足，特别在天国上给他们祝福，给他们荣耀，那是神的心意来的呀。他们世上没有，但是在天国有很大的荣耀啊，那个是神的心意啊。
The Lord Jesus knows very clearly that their life is much tougher than the rich ones, and they are the ones who have been living a tough and difficult life, and that's why the Lord Jesus gives them abundant blessings and the blessings in heaven.
所以你看主耶稣在世的时候常常纪念穷人。
Which is why you see Jesus always remember the poor when he was.
主耶稣在世常常跟贫穷贫苦的人在一起。
Jesus was always amidst those who were poor and needy.
甚至他从天上降下来的时候，也故意的、特意的选择在贫穷人的家里降生啊。
And to the extent he purposefully, intentionally, chose to be born to a poor family.
他为什么要这样做呀？
Why did he do that?
他可以降生在有钱人家，可以就降在王宫啊，可以常常跟那些有钱人在一起啊。你看耶稣有没有这样？
He could have been born in some rich man's house and also the palaces. Did he choose to do that?
并不是说有钱人就不好，不是。
It's not to say that you are bad when you're rich.
因为他们不需要这样的爱，他们也没有这么迫切需要这样的关心。
But perhaps the rich people do not need that much care and love.
你去关心他，他反而觉得你有什么目的想要讨他什么东西呀？他们才不要你的关心的，我跟你讲。
If you attempt to show care and love to these rich people, they might be suspecting you have evil agenda to take their money.
这些贫穷人都是主耶稣所顾念的，是主耶稣所疼爱的。
And these poor people are those that the Lord Jesus remembers and loves.
你却这样的轻视他们。
But you are here to despise them.
我严重的讲，你得罪主耶稣了。这里第五节说的，你得罪神了。
With severity, I want to tell you that you have offended the Lord God.
这不是开玩笑的。
This is no joke.
这第五节讲的，亲爱兄弟，你要听啊，我们得罪了神啊。第五节啊。
Verse 5 tells us that my beloved brethren, we have offended God.
因为这些都是神要拣选、神要祝福的人，我们却轻视他、欺负他。
These are the
让他受伤，让他痛苦呀。
That God has chosen to bless them, and yet we were here to oppress them, to trample upon them.
也不是他们做错什么，或者在教会捣乱，也不是，是因为他们穷。
They did not,
因为他们没有背景，没有亲戚，没有人支持他们，只因为这样。
They did not make mistakes or cause havoc in the church. They simply did not have a lot of networks to the rich people.
所以我才说，我讲这样的时候，我心里是痛的。但是事实上，我今天要讲清楚这些，教会不可以再发生这样的事。
When I have to remember all these cases in our church, I feel really brokenhearted, and I want the church to be clear with it.
你不要跟我讲，那只是他，那他是这样呢？啊，只有他一个信徒这样啊？你们为什么不指责出来呢？你们为什么不阻挡这件事情发生呢？
And stop saying that it is not you, it is not him, it is just the other person. And why wouldn't you dare to stand up for justice?
我怕得罪他，我怕他不高兴哦，我怕他啊，就是问题就在这里了。你怕这个的时候，你也不敢主持公义。你也不敢把公义的道理、公义的信仰表现出来，你也不敢。
And then you say that I do not want to offend the other person. I do not want to hurt anyone's feelings. And that lies the problem because you do not dare to stand up for righteousness.
如果这个事不是发生在我们的教会，我也不会这么生气啊。 那就是发生在我们的教会里面。
If this did not happen in the church, I wouldn't be so furious.
我跟你讲，这些人还很风光在教会的。
But
还非常风光的。
Who offended in this way, are still in the high places.
如果他们听了这个道理，知道了他们再不悔改哈，等着主耶稣的审判吧。
If they were to hear this sermon and they don't repent, may the judgment of God come upon them.
唯有悔改哈，认罪哈，神才会赦免的，才会赦免你这样的罪的。
It is only with your repentance that the Lord God will forgive you.
嗯，大概也大概是20年前吧。有一个传道被派到一个国外去协助圣工。
20 years or so ago, a preacher was sent abroad for the divine work.
而且那个国家呢，不是一般的国家呀。
And that was not any usual country.
讲清楚，直接讲那个国家呢，那个教会呢，那个国家的真耶稣教会呢，是长老级的人才有资格去的，是连总级的人才派去的。其他的国家的传道没有，从来没有被派去的啦，几乎是从来呀。
To be very forthcoming with you, that particular country, those churches or those divine workers assigned there must be above the elders level assigned by the IA only.
那么一个乡下的一个寂寞无名的乡下传道，怎么会派到那边去呢？从没有人认识他的，也没有听过马来西亚的。
So how can
他们都不知道嘛？什么马来西亚？马来西亚在哪里啊？
Now this so-called a Kampong church from Malaysia and the country that no one has heard about, the preacher from this country has been sent there.
这是另外一个背景啊，不用我不讲了。会派去是有原因的啦。
And I don't want to mention about the reason why this preacher was sent from Malaysia.
结果这个传道没有人要接待他。
And this preacher came, then no one was there to receive him.
怎么知道呢
？How do I know
that? 因为那个传道自己也不知道没有人接待啊，他自己都不知道。哎，有啊，还是有人呐、啊，还是有人带他去吃饭呢、啊。
This preacher did not even know that there was supposed to be anyone to receive him.
因为这个传道搞不清楚状况啊。
But this preacher was very unclear with what.
原来他们那边的习惯性呢，接待呢就是一个月哈、哦。如果你在那边一个月，1号到30号呢？就让信徒去填，谁去填啊？早上的、中午啊、中午的、晚上的，看谁要去接待啊，都让你每个人都有机会去接待。
Turned out that there was this practice with an itinerary where whenever there's a foreign preacher that was sent to this country, the members of the local church will have to take time slots every day to take care of this preacher.
那些有名的传道人，那些连总记的，那些有名的长老们是满的啦，一般上的信徒也抢。用抢也抢不到的啦。
But this practice
这个是真实的事情呢、啊。
Was only applicable to the very prominent, very famous elders sent by the International Assembly only.
那么这个乡下传道被派去的时候，那边是空的，很多那些要接待传道要带他去吃饭，空的，空的，空的，整个礼拜的还是空的，只有几个人填呢。那么有一个负责人自己不好意思，这样那里好意思，他又看到这个礼拜没有人填，他又填了几个。啊，在昨天又没有填，他又再填了几个，所以那个名单上看到就是他来的，多数是他的。
Meanwhile，
怎么会这样子呀
？This preacher from Malaysia, this very backwards country.
不要讲马来西亚了，讲乡下了。
This village country, a Kampong church was sent there to this country. No one actually wanted to fill up the space to take care of this preacher, and only the person in charge, in a very embarrassingly, filled some names.
怎么会这样子发生呢？
How did that even happen?
这个就是雅各书这里讲的咯。
That's what has been spoken here.
你是谁呀、啊、
？Who are you?
啊，你从哪里来的呀
？Where do you come from?
你什么资格来到我们这里讲道理呀、啊、
？And
你又不是连总的，又不是长老，又不是什么著名的传道人，你是谁呀、
啊、？What makes you qualified to come to my country to
我讲这些是真真实实，这个就是偏待人。
And I'm telling you these true stories about favoritism.
不是你们没有爱心。
It's not that you don't have love.
如果你们没有爱心，那些传道人来，你们那些有名的人来，你们也不理的呀。不是啊，那既然你们抢着去接待的呀。
If you did not have love, then you wouldn't even care about those famous preachers that come to your country.
我应该现在应该不会再有这样的事了，应该了。
But I believe that this kind of thing should not happen.
我相信已经没有这样的事发生，已经没有了啦。
I believe that this kind of case is no more.
这个就是长大，这个就是好进步了。
That's where our church has progressed, has matured.
这个就是哈、哦、行主耶稣哈、哦、这种公义的道理了。我们不偏待人了、啊， 我们不偏待，有钱来的我们也是这样接待，没有钱来的我们也是这样接待，没有分有钱没有钱。
That's how we finally realized to practice a righteousness and justice taught by Jesus, whether they are poor or rich, we receive them wholeheartedly.
但是这个社会呢，到今天还是一样，叫做先敬罗衣后敬人的社会，先看你的外表穿着。
And this, our today's society is still the same, where we only look at the outer appearance before we serve you.
请注意哦，这是世界的观念，世界的行为啊。
But that is the perspective of this world, the behavior of this world.
若今天真耶稣教会的人，真耶稣教会的工人，真耶稣教会的信徒，仍然是有这种行为，这种观念，你未曾认识真神，你未曾认识他。
If should a member of the True Jesus Church still bear this kind of perspective or this kind of perception, you have not known your God.
你更不认识主耶稣，你不认识主耶稣是怎样的，你根本不认识他。
Nor do you know anything about Jesus
Christ. 你说你认识他，我完全不相信。
You claim that you know Jesus Christ, I don't believe it.
因为一个认识耶稣的人，他绝对不会这样做，也不敢这样做。
Someone who knows Jesus would not dare to do such thing.
所以你的信仰不是真实的。
Therefore, your faith is not true.
因为真实的信仰必定有公义的见证，有公义的表现，有公义的行为，就是不偏待的。
A true and genuine faith that would manifest a righteous and just works with no partiality.
这是第一段。
That's the first passage.
雅各书第二章的第一段，什么叫做真实的信仰？
In the book of James, chapter 2, what is this genuine faith?
所以很清楚哦。
Very clearly.
哦，真实的信仰必须有公义的行为。公义的见证。
The genuine faith must bear just and righteous work.
好，我们进入到第二段。
We enter into the second passage.
什么叫做真实的信仰呢？
What is this genuine faith?
真实的信仰呢，必须遵守至尊的律法。至尊呢，就是全备的律法。
Genuine faith is one that practices a complete and holistic faith.
这个是八节到十三节。
Or law, verse 8 to verse 13.
第九节说，你们若守这第八节，你们若守着至尊的律法才是好的。一个真实的信仰必须遵守至尊的律法，全律法。
A genuine faith is one that fulfills the royal law.
为什么突然间要讲遵守律法呢？为什么
？Why does he suddenly talk about this royal law?
特别是指十条诫命
，especially referring to the Ten Commandments.
因为律法的总纲就是爱呀。
Because the summary of the law is love.
所以第八节说，经上记着说要爱人如己啊。
Verse 8 tells us that it is in the scriptures that you shall love your neighbor as yourself.
那为什么要爱人如己呢
？Why do we love others as ourselves?
这个就是我们遵守这个律法的精神啊，律法所教导的十条诫命的精神啊。
That's the spirit and the attitude with which we fulfill the Ten Commandments.
因为我们圣经很说，我们不需要看了哈。
There's, we are clear with this in scriptures.
就是马太福音书二十二章。
Matthew chapter 22,
36到40节
verse 36 to 40,
就是有人来问耶稣，其实是试探耶稣啦。主啊，先生啊，诫命中哪一条是最大的呀
？Someone came to test Jesus. Oh, sir, what is the greatest commandment in the commandments?、
表面上是很想要知道，追求道理。
He appeared as though he was very inquisitive.
其实那个内心是要试探耶稣。
But his intent was to test Jesus.
他问耶稣的时候是看不起耶稣的，
right.
看你会不会回答呀？
When he threw this question at Jesus, it was to test Jesus whether he would know how to answer.
那主耶稣就说，第一你要爱神啊。
Jesus said that you shall love the Lord your God.
那怎样爱神呢
？How do you do that?
要尽心、尽心、尽意爱你的神啊。
With all your heart, all your soul, and with all your mind.
不是嘴巴说我爱神了，我爱神，你怎样爱神
？It is not by lip service saying that you love God.
尽心
，but with all your heart.
尽心
，with all your soul.
尽你的意
，with all your mind.
Yeah. 那除了爱神，还要爱什么？第二就还。接下来就是要爱人。
What else is then is to love man?
那如何爱人呢
？What how do you love man?
耶稣说的就是要爱人如己。这里的第八节说的爱人好像爱自己这样。
There's a written in verse 8 in James that love your neighbor as yourself.
所以雅各在第八节说，我们除了偏待人没有公义以外，第八节还加上我们没有爱心啊。
And verse 8 tells us that other than with partiality, we treat others without justice, it is also without love.
因为你没有爱人如己啊。
You did not love others as yourself.
前面上面那边是讲你没有公义啊。
The first portion says that you do not have justice.
现在接下来说你没有爱心啊。
And the latter portion says you do not have love.
若你是贫穷可怜的人，你愿意人家这样羞辱你吗？这样的来对待你吗？请问，这样的看不起你、伤害你，你愿意吗？
If you were indeed a person who was poor and needy, would you like to see someone treat you like that?
或者你的孩子这样来教会我们欺负他、讲衰他，好让他受伤？请问你做父母的，你的心怎样呢？你对这个教会有怎样的感想呢？
Perhaps your own child comes to the church and gets bullied and gets despised and looked down upon. How would you feel as a parent?
所以我们这种偏待人的行为啊，在我们的信仰上有两个没有。
This kind of behavior of mistreating people, we have two no's.
第一就是没有公义。
First, you don't have.
第二，没有爱心。
Justice, and secondly, you don't have love.
这样的信仰怎么可能是真实的信仰呢？
How can you claim that this kind of faith is genuine?
这样的信仰怎么可能会有智慧呢？怎么可能是叫做智慧的信仰呢？
How can you call this faith a faith with wisdom?
哦，所以雅各提出严重的警告。
Therefore, Elder James gave us very stern warning.
第十节
，verse ten.
因为凡犯了一条诫命的，就犯了众条了。
Whoever that stumbles in one point of the law, he has stumbled in all of the law.
那十一节他就提出一个 example.
Verse 11 was an example.
那个说不可以奸淫，不可以杀人的，
啊， he said,
但是他不可以，他没有奸淫，可是他跑去杀人啊，那也是犯法了。
He said that he does not commit adultery, but he has commit adultery, and he has also become a transgressor of the whole law.
这什么意思呢？
What does that mean?
这就好像亚当在吃禁果这样。
It is likened to Adam eating the forbidden fruit.
神说不可以吃。
God said it is forbidden.
他跟神说，我是有吃了，但是我吃一口罢了哦，我咬一口罢了哦，我的太太哦，咬完他三口、四口、五口，全部都是他吃的，我只是咬一口罢了。
Adam could have argued that I only had one bite of the apple of the fruit, but my wife had three bites or even more.
请问你吃一口跟你吃到完有差别吗？在神来看有差别吗？在你犯这个诫命上有差别吗？
Is there any difference for you to have one bite or even more than one bite? Does it make you any different in terms of your transgression?
一样的，你说我只是犯奸淫吗？我又没有杀人，我只是犯奸淫，就好像亚当说我只是咬一口而已。你咬一口跟咬两口、咬三口还有差别吗？已经没有差别了。
The same, you can compare with this. If you have committed adultery and you did not commit murder, and would it mean that your transgression is lesser?
因为十条诫命里面的爱，你犯任何一条，就是你没有爱人，你也没有爱神。你有爱神或者爱人，你就不会去做这种事，你不会去杀人啊，不会去伤害人啊，对不对？
Should you
不会去贪人家的东西啊。
In all the Ten Commandments, should you have violated one of them, that also means that you have failed in loving God and loving man.
所以十二节说
，Verse 12，
既然信耶稣了，就要遵照主耶稣的诫命来行啊。十二节、啊、
，Since you have decided to believe in Christ, you ought to do as by the law of Christ.
照诫命来说话，照诫命来行事啊。十二节
，Speak and do according to the law of liberty.
嗯，今天传道我们讲道理也是这样，照主的话来说，照诫命来行，照诫命来警告啊。
The speakers, the preachers, and the elders on the pulpit must also preach according to the law.
但是你们却看成传道在骂人啊。
But you
你们是这样讲、这样看的呀。
But you deem the preacher as only scolding you.
你怎么不去看说传道是在讲神的律法、讲神的诫命呢？
Why
你为什么不这样看呢？
Why can't you tell that the preacher is talking about the law of God?
好，那十三节是什么呢？
Verse 13.
十三节就是个结论。
It is a conclusion.
嗯。因为那不怜悯人的，也要受无怜悯的审判。
For he who judge without mercy will be shown no mercy.
为什么突然间要讲怜悯呢？
Why is mercy brought into the picture?
原来因为将来有一个大审判要存在、啊、
Because there is going to be a final judgment in the last days.
而且将来的审判呢，也是按照诫命、神的律法、诫命来审判的。
And this judgment is going to be executed according to the law of God.
这是主耶稣亲自证实的。
That has also been testified by Jesus personally.
你自己去看约翰福音书十二章。
You look at the John chapter 12,
47-48.
Verse 47-48.
耶稣说他来不是要定人家的罪的，他不是，他是要来救人的。
Jesus said that he did not come to condemn people.
可是到末日的时候，到那个时候有审判他的。
But on the last day, in the end times, there will be one who judges.
用什么来审判？
Judges on based on.
所以说，我的道，我所讲的道理，就是神的话，神的道理要审判他。用神的话，主耶稣所讲的来审判他。
The judgment shall be executed according or based on the word of the Lord Jesus Christ.
所以你就知道为什么雅各长老讲诫命，突然间讲怜悯，讲审判。
Therefore, you understand now that when James talked about the law, he suddenly talked about mercy.
如果我们没有爱心，我们没有行出公义，我们没有遵守律法， 我们这样的叫受到大审判呀，它的重点在这里啊。
His central message is to say that if you do not practice love and also practice the law of God, then we will be subject to eternal judgment.
但是呢，神是怜悯的。
But God is merciful.
他总给我们啊，他总是哦、要救我们。
And God desires to save us.
所以他接下去说，怜悯原来是向审判夸胜的。
And here he tells us that that mercy is to it will triumph over judgment.
意思说，将来我们除了哈。守神的诫命，我们不去犯罪，不去拜偶像，不去做坏事。除了这些，
from,
我们将来的得救还是要加上神的怜悯，靠神的怜悯才可以进去的。
Aside from our works of keeping the word of God, keeping the law of God without practicing evil but practicing love, that also depends entirely on the mercy of God.
因为我们虽然没有做这些大恶，但是小过犯啊、骄傲啊、贪心啊、种种啊，我们还是有的呀。还是会犯的呀。
Perhaps we have not committed the wicked sins or large or cardinal sins, but we have also committed minor sins.
所以那到那时还是需要主耶稣怜悯，主啊怜悯我吧，主耶稣你赦免我吧。
And in that day of judgment, you still need the mercy of God to forgive you.
所以这里这样说。
Therefore, it's stated here.
有原文字界翻译这样说。
In the original text.
对于那些不行怜悯的人，审判就没有怜悯。我再重复一次， For... 对那些不行怜悯的人。审判就没有怜悯。
To the one who has shown no mercy, judgment will be without mercy upon him as well.
我们中文翻译是怜悯原是向审判夸胜。
And in Chinese translation, mercy is one which will triumph over judgment.
原来原文字界说，你如果不行怜悯，你也不去怜悯人家，那么你审判的时候呢，神也不会对你怜悯的。
It is correctly translated in English from original text that if you do not show mercy, your judgment upon you will not be with mercy.
那些穷人，那些可怜人，你没有怜悯他们，没有同情他们，你还看不起他们，你还去欺负他们，还大小声去骂他们，你是谁呀、啊？你
？To the poor and needy.
你凭什么骂人家呀、啊？
To the poor and needy, you have not shown any sympathy, empathy, or even mercy, and you despise them, you scold them, and who are you to even do that?
他又没有得罪你，他也没有拿你的钱，也没有骗你，也没有伤害你，他只是坐在那边，也没有说这个地方是我的，也没有，他怎么知道呀？
These people didn't even do any harm to you, and all they did was only to sit in your seat, and you, and what else did they do wrong?
你不但只骂他，你给很难看的脸色他呀。
And you not only scolded them, you also gave them a very
bad face. 请问你这种态度，你这种，请问你有怜悯他吗？你有怜悯他呀
？Do you have mercy?
将来主耶稣在这圣经说，你既然不会怜悯人，你审判的时候也不会怜悯你。哦，原文是说，对那些不行怜悯的人，审判就没有怜悯。
And
就直接的审判他。
As is written in the scriptures, that to the one who has shown no mercy, the judgment upon him is also without mercy.
求主耶稣赦免我们吧。
May the Lord Jesus forgive us.
将来如何让我们更有把握的站在审判台前
？For us to be able to have a greater confidence to stand before the judgment throne.
这里启示我们说，到最后仍然需要主耶稣怜悯，请注意。
Now this is a revelation to us that at the very end, on the last day, we still need the mercy of God.
那最后一段，最后一段。
The last passage.
真实的信仰是怎样的呢
？What is this genuine faith?
就是十四节到二十六节最后一段。
Verse 14 to 26.
原来真实的信仰必须是信心与行为是并行的，一起的。
A genuine faith is one that is aligned and parallel to his works.
所以十四节说，有人说他有信心却没有行为，这个有什么益处呢？
Verse 14 says that if one says he has faith but has no works, what is so beneficial?
他这种信心，他这种信仰，请问能够救他吗？
Can this kind of faith save him?
我们上一回说过南山的老虎不吃基督徒这个故事了、哦、
In the previous session, we shared about the story of the tiger in Nanshan does not eat the Christians.
这种嘴巴的行为没有行为的，只是嘴巴，我信耶稣啊，我是也信耶稣啊，我是主的儿女，有用吗？能救他吗？到时。
And there came a Christian who only professes about Christianity, but has no works, and would that even save him from a tiger's mouth?
那十五节到十六节。
And from 15 to 16.
雅各就提出真实在生活上常常见的例子，甚至在教会里面常看到的例子。
James pointed out some examples that he saw in the church that truly happened.
若是弟兄或是姐妹赤身露体，又缺乏日用的饮食，你们中间就是指教会人哦。你们中间有人对他说：“哎呀，愿你平安啊，主耶稣祝福你啦，平平安安去吧。” 我们今天常常看到这样，常常听到这样的事。
You see someone with a lot of lacking and destitute of daily food who is very poor, and one of you in the church say to him that depart in peace, be warmed and filled.
更虚假的时候，我会为你祷告，更加虚假。
And isn't this very hypocritical that I will pray for you? Don't worry.
现在不需要替他祷告啊，他也没有什么大问题，他是缺乏需用啊，他贫穷啊，他孩子没有奶粉吃呀。难道你祷告叫主耶稣从天上掉一罐奶粉给他吗？难道是这样吗？那不然你祷告什么呢？你说我替你祷告是祷告什么呢？
Is it his current top priority for your prayer, or would your prayer be able to bring some milk from heaven or some food from heaven that he might be fed?
那最直接就是马上去买一罐给他，或者给他钱去买，就直接帮助到他的，直接解决问题的。
Your most immediate action should be to buy a can of milk or some food for him to feed him.
不用讲到这么属灵啊，祷告啊，什么呀，代祷啊，不用了，直接吧。
Don't have to be so spiritual about your words, just to say, I'll pray for you.
这个就是我们的行为咯，信心跟行为是一起并行的咯。
That's your works and your faith and your works must come in tandem.
那雅各对这样的信仰做了一个结论，如果我们的信仰是这样的。
Elder James made a conclusion about that kind of behavior.
就是一直讲信心讲属灵，但是没有行为的。
The behavior which only talks about your faith and spiritual things, but you have no works.
17节。
Verse 17.
这样的信心若没有行为就是死的。
Faith by itself, if it does not have works, is dead.
因为时间关系，我没有办法讲十八节哦。
I want to go to verse 18.
十八节是因为有人挑战雅各长老了，说、yes. 不是的，不是这样的，信心就是信心，行为就是行为，是分开的。不是并行的，十八节就有人挑战这个长老。
Verse 18, was someone challenging Elder James, saying that it is you are not right. You have faith, I have works.
我没有时间进入里面去分析哈。
I don't have time to analyze.
那雅各长老就举出三个例子啊，四个例子哦，来讲信心跟行为是并行的。
Elder James brought up four examples that faith and your works must come in tandem.
第一个长老提出什么呢？
Firstly, what the elder James said.
他说魔鬼也信神啊，十九节。
Verse 19, that even the devil believes in God.
你们信神只有一位，不要以为只有你信，你信的不错，连魔鬼也是信啊，信独一真神啊。
You talk so highly about your faith and you believe there's one God, but even the demons believe that.
不过魔鬼的这种相信有用啊。
And is the faith of the demons going to help?
他只是在那边害怕，在那边恐惧，在那边害怕而已。
All they will do will be trembling in fear.
哎，请注意哈。那个圣经哦，耶稣在世的时候哦，魔鬼跟耶稣讲一句话，里面我们发现到魔鬼相信四件事情。
And in the Bible tells us that the devil spoke to Jesus, and the devil says believe in four things.
就是耶稣要去赶他的时候，他跟耶稣说，我跟你有什么关系啊？你现在来赶我啊？
When Jesus was casting out these demons, and demons spoke to Jesus, and what do I have with you? Why are you casting me out?
我知道你是谁，你是神的圣者，你是神的圣者。
I know who you are. You are the Holy One from God.
那你要去看就看马太福音第八章。
You can refer that to Matthew chapter 8,
28-29节。
Verse 28-29.
魔鬼讲这句话，我们发现到他相信四件事。
When the Satan said that, and we know that they believe four things.
第一，他相信有神。
Firstly, they believe in God.
而且是独一真神。
They believe in one true God.
第二
，Second,
他相信基督，相信弥赛亚耶稣基督。
They believe in Christ, the Messiah.
第三
，Thirdly,
他相信有审判。
They believe in judgment.
第四
Fourthly,
他相信审判的那个日子他一定受很大的痛苦。
The demons also believe that on the day of judgment, they shall be subject to terrible suffering.
不只有审判，而且会受很大的痛苦。
Not only judgment, but terrible suffering.
这个就是魔鬼所相信的呀。
This is what the demons also believe.
也是他所知道的呀。
And also what they know.
马太福音书八章。
Matthew chapter 8,
28-29, 你自己再去看一下。
Verse 28-29, please read yourselves.
但是这种信心雅各提出来，他没有行为的，他是相信啊，但是没有行为的，请问有用吗
？James said this is also faith, but this is without works. Would that help?
他知道有审判，他知道独一真神，可是他有敬畏他吗？他有顺服他吗
？James says that
他有去赞美他吗？
The demons know there will be judgment, and would the demons be praising God and be worshiping God?
不但是没有，还抵挡神，还控告神，还去破坏神的工作呀。
Not only do the demons not worship God, they are also there to retaliate to destroy the works of God.
请问这种信有用吗
？Is this kind of faith going to
save? 长老要讲的就是说，他有信，但是没有行为的。
It's trying to say that this is also faith, but they have no work.
第二个例子。
Second example,
就是21-24节。
21-24。
长老提出亚伯拉罕的信心跟他的行为，现以下的事情。
Elder James brought up the faith of Abraham while he offered Isaac.
那我们就不用再讲了嘛，哈。
Needless to mention.
时间关系。第三，他提出妓女拉合的信心跟行为。
And later on, he also brought up the faith of Rahab, the prostitute.
那是在二十四节。
That's in verse 24.
哦，要拉。拉赫这个妓女，这个拉赫呢，他说他相信，可是他有行为的，他有动作的，他真的是协助那些那两个探子的，他是站在神那一边的，站在以色列人那一边的，真的有行为看得见的呀。
Verse 25 also tells us that Rahab did not only believe in God, but she also manifested actions to stand by the side of God.
这是在耶稣雅记第二章里面的内容很多。
This is the content of Joshua chapter 2.
长老又提出第四个证据。
And the fourth evidence.
第四个证据是什么呢
？What is that?
就是身体跟灵魂的比喻。
The analogy between the soul and the spirit and the body.
如果一个身体哈，身体没有灵魂，那就是肯定是死的。
The body without the spirit is dead.
我们今天的我们还活着，因为这个身体，因为灵魂在我们身体啊，所以活着呀。所以身体跟灵魂是并行的，是合在一起的。
Now we are well and alive because our body and our spirits are working in tandem at our coexisting.
信心没有行为，就好像灵魂离开身体，那就会死的。信心，因为他信心没有行为的，那个是会死的，因为就好像肉体里面、身体里面没有灵魂的。
Therefore, faith without works is likened to the body without the spirit is also dead.
这四个见证呢，例子呢，是要反驳十八节的那些不信的人，那些反对的人。
These four examples or these four evidence are brought up by Elder James to rebut against those people who challenged him in verse 18.
那么在这一段里面，他一共讲了三次，信心没有行为是死的，一共讲三次，请你去找。
In this short passage, you can count yourself that there are three times where Elder James said, faith without works is dead.
有没有三次还是四次
Or was there four times?
好，这个就是真实信仰与虚假信仰的分别了。
This is the differentiation between the true and genuine faith and the false faith.
最后我谈到雅各书雅各在本章里面谈到三种信仰，
There were three kinds of faith mentioned by Elder James in this chapter.
第一个叫做死的信仰。
First is the faith which is dead.
死的信仰就是没有行为的信仰，只有一直讲信心啊，讲属灵啊，但是没有行为的。
This dead faith is one which professes about faith or spiritual words but have no work.
只会讲我们爱神啊，我们要守安息日啊，但是没有行为的。
They talk loudly about loving God and loving the church, but have no work.
兄弟啊，这种信仰，雅各长老说，这个是死的信仰。
And brethren, this is a dead faith.
好，第二种信仰
，second type
叫做魔鬼式的信仰，魔鬼式的信仰。
The faith of the demons.
魔鬼式，是那个
the demonized faith.
魔鬼 style 的信仰。
The style of the demon.
Yeah. 什么叫做魔鬼 style 的信仰呢
？What is this demon style faith?
他信神啊。
They believe God.
他也信独一神啊。
They also believe in one true God.
可是他没有来敬拜神。
But they don't worship God.
他还抵挡神的呀。
They resist God.
抵挡真理的呀。
They oppose the truth.
然后他虽然信了，可是他恐惧，他不是平安的，他是恐惧的呀。
They believe in God, but they believe in trembling.
这个叫做魔鬼 style 的信仰。
This is a demon style faith.
我为什么这样讲
？Why am I saying that?
因为在我们教会里面，你看得到这种魔鬼式的信仰，真的看得到。
You can actually find this kind of believers who have this kind of faith.
你没有看到有些人，有一些这种信仰存在在教。你看不到的吗
？Haven't you noticed and observed our members？
他们说是真耶稣教会的，说已经洗礼很多年的。
They claim that they belong to the True Jesus Church.
你看他们怎样对待真耶稣教会
？But how do they treat the True Jesus？
他们怎样攻击真耶稣教会
？How do they attack the Church？
他们怎样来反对我们讲的真理
？How do they oppose our truth？
这不是魔鬼式的信仰，他信啊，可是他一直反对的，一直对付，一直摧毁这个教会的，不是巩固这个教会的呀。
Isn't that the faith of the demons where they believe in God but they resist the truth and they resist the church?
这些魔鬼是有一些是传道人来的。
Some of these were preachers.
那是很严重的事来的。
It is very severe.
有一些是长子来的。
Some were elders.
有一些是信徒弟兄姐妹来的。
Some were brothers and sisters.
都有这种魔鬼式的信仰。
Who have this faith of the demons?
当然，有一些已经自己离开了，他不要在这里了，他已经待不下去了。
And surely some of them chose to depart from the church and they can't stay.
传道也有，长子也有，信徒有，有一些出去了，自己出去了。
And some of them they decided to leave the church themselves.
有一些被除名，直接被除名了。
And there were also some who were excommunicated.
可是我告诉你，还有一些留在教会，没有被除名，也没有自己走的，还在。
But let me tell you the truth that there are still some of you who are still in the church who were not excommunicated.
不知道什么时候又在大地震，在大爆发而已。
We are not sure when this ticking bomb would explode.
他们信啊。
They believe in God.
但是对付真理的，反对教会的。
But they oppose the truth. They attack the church.
请注意哦，这叫做魔鬼式的信仰。
Take note that is known as the faith of the demons.
我在准备的时候，我自己都吓一跳哦。原来教会有这样的信仰啊。 我在准备的时候，以前我们就说魔鬼也信啊，但是我们就是带过而已啊。但是你今天在进入里面去看，就在教会里面。
In the past, we just said that even the demons believe, but you realize that this is also the kind of faith, so-called faith for the demons, which exists.
而且这种信仰呢，他会对付神中心的工人，他一定会对付他。中心的工人，他一定要对付，他一定讨厌这种工人。
This kind of faith that would be to attack the members who are faithful to God.
因为这种工人，这些工人对他威胁很大，他感觉到不安全。
Because the faithful workers of God are the greatest threat to them.
请你注意看。
Take note of that.
那第三种信仰是什么？
What's the third type of faith?
那就是活的信仰。
Faith which is living.
活的信仰就是能够救我们的信仰。
The living faith is one which saves.
原来活的信仰就是信心与行为是并行的，信心有行为的。
The living faith is one where his faith and his works are in tandem.
所以，请问这三种信仰里面，三种信心里面，我们是属于哪一种？
In these three types of faith, which faith is yours?
大家要记得。
Take note of that.
第二章里面有三种信仰。
In chapter 2, there are three types of faith.
哪一种才是第二章里面的主题？真实的信仰。
Which of these three faith is this genuine faith?
请唱诗。
Let's sing him. 395.
谢谢你。395.
395.